Let's bless each other. You may be in peace. You are the evangelist to save the world. And you may enjoy the blessing of restoring 10,000 church members in this era. From one day, our first service choir, they really gained a lot of strength, and then it really gives me a lot of grace. It seems like their spiritual state became much better. It used to be like that, but since I can like really physically feel that, I think they're really receiving a lot of grace. So they come to church early to prepare for their praise, and I really give you, express my gratitude to all the choir members. Today, I was preparing for this worship in my room, and about 8:40, all the choir members, they came up to this room to prepare for worship. And it was really great to see them preparing for this worship diligently. As a church, we are preparing some new measures for worship, for service. And we really want to implement a new measure in order to focus only on word, praise, and service as a whole. So before we start this worship, as our church choir members came to this building much earlier to prepare for this worship, so you may also come to this room earlier than you used to really prepare, to really pray for the service before it begins. So what we will be doing is we want to implement a new measure for you to really focus on God's word only. So that's what we are doing. So if you look at the service guidance like paper, it's really complicated, but what we want to do in the future is that we want to make it much simpler. So since we renovated this building, that's why we also want to remodel our service procedures, etc. And also, you will see a lot of those people who are guiding the worship. They also, their like uniforms has been changed as well. So we wanted to really let our church members know that they are there to help you. So they're wearing scarf, and it's really, they're very beautiful. What about male members who guide this service? They are also prepared with new uniform, not the black jacket or pants. But we have prepared something that's very new and fresh. Why do we do that? It's because all the church members who attend this first worship, they sit on the same kind of seat. So, but please don't do that in the future. Our church member who will guide this service will guide you through all the seats that's available. So you may really follow that procedure. And if you really have to say amen during the worship, then you can just say that. I talk a lot of things during the first worship because I feel much comfortable. But it's such a great grace
영적인 힘이 없이는
without spiritual strength, we cannot triumph over this end time. That's why you may really focus on this worship as well as word, praise, and everything so that you can triumph in your field for this week. You can really be fueled to win over your field.
눈에 보이는 것도 중요하지만은 더 중요한 것이
something visible is can be considered important, but what's invisible is more important.
Es muy importante el respaldo que no se ve ante
invisible background is important.
And 흐름이 있습니다. 그 흐름이 중요합니다.
There is also a flow. And that's also important. You have your individual flow, your family flow, and church also has its own flow. This is what I've emphasizing a lot. But all the problems or all the graces that you received from God that also came from your background. So thinking about our church's flow,
힘을 해보하는
시간이었습니다.
As I was preparing for this word, I received a lot of grace thinking about that. Our church's flow is God's absolute sovereignty. God continuously imprinted His word to our hearts. And those words imprinted in our hearts really led us to confess that everything is in God's sovereignty. Even in the midst of disease, our church members were able to confirm God's sovereignty even in the midst of their difficult situation. So that was really great grace. And that's the most important matters in walking the Christian life. So we emphasize a lot about God's sovereignty. If you do not believe that, then it will be a lot of obstacle as you live your Christian life. What about something else? One person actually wrote a phrase for me. And something like a phrase was written saying that I'm really grateful that Hana Church is only exists for mission works and world evangelization. And I think that are also the flows of our church. All the creatures in this world also have their own flow. And if you are thinking about God's word, there is also flow. And the most important thing about God's the flow of God's word is mission, evangelization, and Church of Seven Nations. What's the title for today's message? It's You Will Live Long
in the Land.
It means your day will be continued. All the things in this world never last forever.
Only
what belongs to God can stay forever.
We
are holding on to the eternal thing that belongs to God. That's mission, evangelization, and 237 nations. That's what belongs to God, and we're holding on to that. As we are holding on to that things, we will be in the eternal mystery of God. Not only our generation, but also our future generations. These blessings will be continued. That's why we are currently praying for Hana RUTC.
회복된 이 복음의 역사들이 끊어지지 않도록
so that
우리 후대에게 올바른 복음을 전달해서
mystery of gospel doesn't
흘러가도록 하자.
Get disconnected so that we can relay this blessing to our posterity. That's why Hana RUTC is made of.
시스템은 우리가 이렇게 시스템 맞춘 만든 부분들이 무엇 때문입니까?
What about all the new systems of our church?
우리가 편한 환경 속에 좋은 환경 속에서 예배 드리기 위해서가 아닙니다.
It's not because we just want to have a better place to worship. But it's because for our next generation so that they can prepare for the next generation in this place, in this new place.
제대로 알기만 해도 여러분에게 모든 응답들이
If you can really realize this blessing, then all the grace will be upon you. If you look at the Bible, there is one person that lived longer than other people, any other people in the Bible. He lived more than 900 years.
죽음을 보지 않고 하늘로 올려진 에녹의
And he was actually the child of Enoch who didn't die but was just resurrected. But the son didn't have strength to relay this gospel to his children. But God let him to live more than 900 years without with a reason.
그의 증손자인 셈, 함, 야벳에게 이 언약을 전달하는 일에 심부름했던 것을 보게 됩니다.
He lived that longer in order to relay the covenant to his posterity. And the grace of God continued more than 900 years. We, our family, also have to receive that kind of grace. The grace that we will be receiving in the future should be continued for our posterity and our future generations. In order to enjoy this blessing,
지금 시간이 그렇게 많이 없기 때문에 두 가지만
I want to point out two things. The first point is always walk with God's word.
Siempre estemos junto a la palabra.
쉽게 말하면은 여러분 안에 다른
것 가진 말고 don't imprint any other thing but imprint God's word in your heart.
여러분 하나님의 말씀과 항상 동행하는 것은
You must walk with God's word and that's the basic life as a believer.
우리가 교회 오고 가고 갑니다.
We go to church, we come home, and we do a lot of things, we do a lot of works, and that's also important. But if you do not walk with God's word, then your Christian life will be burdened and be weary.
신앙생활하면서도 말씀과
As you live your Christian life, if you do not walk with God's word, then it's really difficult for you to live your life in this world. If you look at the Bible scripture that we read today, this is the message for Israelites that are about to enter the Canaan land. Canaan land was full of 12 different kinds of life problems. And if Israelites, they do not enjoy God's grace, God's mystery in that land, no matter how the Canaan land is flourishing, it doesn't matter because they will misunderstand a lot of things in the Canaan land. What does it mean? It means no matter how you put your great efforts in this world, but you will leave God in eventually. Why is that? It's because
하나님을 알게 하고 하나님을 만나게 하는 것이 아니에요.
Through world, you cannot meet God.
세상이 악한 사단이 붙잡고 있기 때문에
because this world is seized by wicked Satan. It will eventually separate you from God.
하나 que el hombre se separe que no conozca de Dios.
그래서 오늘 본문에서 당부하는 내용이 있다면은 계속해서 하나님의 말씀을 잘 누르면서
So there's one part in the Bible scripture that we read today emphasizing it's emphasizing that you have to walk with God's word all the time. And actually Deuteronomy chapter 32 is the song of Moses.
하면서 살아가도록 하기 위해서 이 말씀을 노래로 부르면서 각인하라는 겁니다.
So Moses tried to imprint this message with rhythm so that he can really imprint this word in his heart. So if you look
30절 보면 나옵니다.
이다미네 베르시클로 30.
모세가 이스라엘 총회에 이 노래의 말씀을 끝까지 읽어 들리니라 말씀했고요.
It said that Moses really imprinted this word. And also, if you look at 32,
내가 말하리라 땅은 내 입의 말을 들을지어다 했습니다.
Dice escucha cielo y hablaré y oiga la tierra los dichos de mi
boca. All things will hear this message. That's what Moses said. So up to what point do you have to enjoy this message, imprint this message?
별로 표시가 안 나는 것 같아요.
If it rains very slightly, then you do not really recognize it.
표시가 안 나는 것처럼 되면서 촉촉하게 스며들잖아요.
It just gives you a sense of like moisture, but you cannot really recognize that it rained. But I think God's word are also like that. So when you listen to God's word, you may think that, oh, it's useless. But it's not true. Just like you are soaked with a slight rain as time passes by, as you listen to God's word, you will be soaked with God's word. That's a great blessing. So those who do not miss the direction of God's word, then those people will not lose his way, and those people will enjoy God's grace in their life. If you look at Psalms, who can we call is really blessed person? Those who meditate on God's word day and night and enjoy his word. Those who enjoy God's word day and night and all the things that that person do will be prosper. So don't do other kind of thing, but you must implement all your works in God's word. As you start this week, you can think of why, what brought you here. You shouldn't live your life focusing on your own strength or your own way, but you came here in order to receive God's word and really bring that word to your field. Then what blessings will you have? So if you look at Acts 2:42, it says they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship, to the breaking of the bread and to prayer. So it says apostles' teaching. And that teaching actually continued to save Rome, the country of Rome. So you may really confirm God's word, and in the flow of his word, you may be guided every aspect of your life.
나의 생각과 나의 노래가 되도록 각인하시길 바랍니다.
Up to the point where this word really can be your song. If you can really enjoy God's word, then you can really sing out of it. Then you can really imprint God's word more efficiently.
계획 없이
without any having any plan,
without
like even realizing, you sometimes
분위기를 보지 아니하고
humming.
그냥 생각과 계획 없이 나도 모르게 터져 나오는 흥얼거리는 노래들이
so without even you realizing that you're singing, you sometimes like sing.
어릴 때에 자기도 모르게
a certain written.
That
happens because that song was imprinted in you, in your young, from your young age.
이렇게 마이크 테스트하다 나도 모르게 옛날 유행가가 이렇게
나왔어요.
So the other day, I was checking if the microphone is working, and I kind of like sang popular song. And one person, one of our church members, said, "Pastor, you sang a popular song."
So,
something that was imprinted in you in your young age just come out from you certainly, suddenly. What song was that? I can introduce that to you. In the early morning, I wake up.
잠에서 깨어 주를 바라볼 수 있다면 얼마나 좋습니까?
And it
would be really good if I can look to God in the morning when I wake up. So that was the pop song that I sang. Checking my microphone.
여러분 말씀을 누리게 되면은
So if you enjoy God's word, then you will live long in this land. The blessing, that's the blessing. So if you look at verse 46 to 47, he said to him, Take to her all the words I have declared to you this day, so that you may command your children to obey carefully all the words of the law. They're not just idle words for you, they are your life. By them you will live long in the land you're crossing the Jordan to possess.
So we'll live long in the land. Pasando el Jordán para tomar posesión.
So up to the point where this word really can be your rhythm, your song, then you will also receive the same kind of blessing. You will live long in the land and you will be used by God for His works. If you look at verse 44, Moses and Joshua finished relaying these words to Israelites. So you can actually witness that Moses and Joshua, the successor of Moses, Joshua, they stand together to deliver God's word to Israelites. So Moses were very aged and Joshua was relatively new, but God's word never changes. If you look hear what young people say, they say that they cannot really be connected to older people because of generational differences. Yes, maybe, but as for the spiritual problems, it doesn't matter if time it doesn't get affected by generational issues because
이렇게 생각하지 않을 수 없는 부분들로 나타나게 됩니다.
That existed in a long time ago, but still we can witness that we have the same kind of spiritual problem in this era. So we sang today. We just really have to hold onto God's word forever.
우리 어릴 때부터 우리 아이들에게 이 말씀을 각인시킨 것이 너무나 중요한 것이죠.
Especially, it would be really important to imprint this word to our posterity.
So
if you look at verse 46,
먼저 너희 마음에 두라 했어.
Put this word in your heart and command to your children so that they can obey carefully all the words of this law up to the point where you can really relay this word to your children to the point where your children can obey to God's word. You have to transmit this message. If you look at the characteristics of those people who succeed from their young age, they imprinted God's word from their young age. If you look at Joseph, Samuel, they did that, right? Especially for Samuel, Hannah, his mother prayed for his son so that Samuel can be the follower of Jesus, of God. And Samuel went up to the temple of God. He stayed there, and then Samuel's parents, on a special occasion, the parents made a new clothes for Samuel to the temple and gave the clothes to Samuel. What it really means is that the parents of Samuel, they relayed God's word to Samuel. And during Samuel lived in that era, there was no war, and then no single word of Samuel touched the ground. So it will be really important to imprint God's word from our children's young age. What about Timothy? He also realized God's word from his young age. And that word was relayed by his mother, Eunice, and grandmother as well. What about Eli? He lost God's word, and his children all perished. All the disasters and spiritual problems that happens in this world cannot be solved by any other method in this world. It seems like this world is flourishing, but it crumbles and fall over and over again. It's bound to be like that. In order to win over in this world, God has given us an eternal covenant. That's God's word. If you look at Isaiah 40, it says, all things go dry, but God's word stands forever. What covenant does this word suggest? Simply put, that's Christ, God's word, and Holy Spirit. All the words in the Bible was summarized into this three covenants. So, you really have to run God's errand of relaying this word to your children. And the second point, how can you receive this blessing? That's true holy meditation for the gospel every single day. In other words, you really have to be rooted down in the gospel. If you look at verse 47, it says, this is something not vain, but that's your life. Lots of church members, they cannot understand this word. It seems like you are sitting here for 1 hour to receive God's word, and it seems like it's vain, but it is not. That's what verse 47 is talking to you. Something about gospel cannot be vain. God's word cannot be vain. So if you are really blessed children of God, you are bound to follow and obey to God's word. If you look at one Bible scripture, day and night you have to meditate on God's word, it says, then that words will be your life. That's what verse 47 is talking about. They're not just idle words for you, but they're your life. So you can be rooted down on the gospel. And that blessing will be manifested in your all relative fields. To up to what point? If you look at Matthew, it says something about seeds. This is just very little seed, but because that seed has white life, that's why it will be eventually a tree and fruit. It will also generate fruit. If you can be really rooted down on the gospel, then you can receive the same kind of blessing. Simply put, that's the blessing of God's kingdom. Moses is he's a great figure.
사실은 모세가 120세 죽었지만은
하나님
부르심 받았지만은 건강은 여전하게 건강했어.
At about 150 years, more than, but he was very healthy even when he reached that age. Because the Bible is saying like that. And also when Israelites, they committed crime against God, but Moses prayed to God to forgive his people's sins. If you look at the book of Exodus, Israelites, they created an idol, and Moses prayed for them. Moses said to God, please save our people. You can erase my name from the book of life. That's what he said to God. But Moses, one time, he were very angry. He said something like this. That's the incident that happened in the chapter 32. So Moses, he argued to God just one time, but God blocked Moses entering the Canaan land. So Moses gave water to his people. Moses were very angry. He led his people to drink this water. It's not because he argued God. Moses was a leader, but he kind of felt that because he was a leader chosen by God, that's why he thought all the problems he has to solve on his own. It's not just one time kind of event, but that was his nature, that was his root, that carrying out all the things on his own. God is providing you all the messages. You really, in order to make you to be rooted down on the gospel. As much as you can imprint God's message and be rooted down on the gospel, you will receive all the blessings that things are added for your life. Let me close this worship. Today we have a special ceremony. You are the children of God. You celebrate the blood and the flesh of Jesus Christ. You memory. So through this ceremony, you may really be rooted down on God's word. And I really bless all of you so that you can restore the blessing of God's kingdom. So let me start the ceremony.